All right, welcome to Falcon Football tonight. It's the Heights Falcons versus the Southeast Buffaloes. And the Southeast Buffaloes come into this game 1-4 with a win over North. And the Falcons come into this game 3-2 with wins over North, West, and South and losses to Northwest and Garden City. And here come the Falcons now. Tonight is a pink out game with the student section and some of the crowd in pink, and all the boys have pink socks on tonight. They're in the black uniforms and white pants. And our captains for tonight are DJ Dingle, Isaiah Yehuda, Nate Campbell, and Kale Millison for the Falcons. And as the band's coming off the field, out come the captains. Captains for Heights again, number 2, DJ Dingle, number 4, Kale Millison, number 10, Nate Campbell, and number 8, Isaiah Yehuda. The Heights Falcons come into this on a 3-game win streak. All but one of them has been a shutout with lots of points scored. Here's the flip of the coin. They're looking it over. It's hard to tell who won the toss from up here, but looks like Heights has elected to receive the kickoff. Not sure who won the coin flip, but we're going to see the Heights offense out on the field to start the game. Another lot of energy on the sideline for the Falcons here as they're getting ready to receive the kick. Back to receive for the Falcons is number 12, Lafayette Washington, and number 5, John Randall. And also it looks to be number 6, Avante Scales. And in the box helping tonight we have Derek, Adrian, Jacob, and Evan? Ivan running the scoreboard tonight. So we've got a good crew in here tonight, and we're ready to watch some football. Number 68 for the Southeast Buffaloes to kick off. One of the bigger kickers we've seen this year. That is number 68, Martin Lopez, off to kick it away to start the game. They onside to start. And the Southeast kick team seems like they looked like they fall on it, but I saw a I saw black jerseys on the ball first. Heights, so it's Heights football, and we're starting the game in some pretty good field position here on the 40. Looks at the on the 49 yard line here. Nope. Right on the 50 actually. We've got DJ Dingle in the backfield to take the snap at quarterback. Cale Millison at fullback. John Randall at running back. And we got motioning Kamar Alexander out. He takes the pitch from DJ Dingle. Turns up field for a great gain. And for a touchdown for the Falcons, a 50-yard run to start the game. Wow, that's the second game in a row where the Falcons on the first play have started with a score. That was number 14, Kamar Alexander, on the jet sweep there to score for the Falcons. He really showed the speed on that one. And now the Falcons are going for a two-point conversion. Looks to be number 4, Cale Millison, in the backfield at running back. And we've got number 5, John Randall, and number 9, Tavion Johnson at wide receiver. Keep by DJ Dingle, and he takes it in for a two-point conversion. And that is Heights 8, Southeast 0 with 11:46 left in the first quarter, so a really quick score by the Falcons there. Not a great decision for the Buffaloes to onside kick to start the game and give us that great field position with how explosive this Falcon offense is. Now the Falcons are here to kick off, and kicking for the Falcons is number 55, Kerryon Harrison-Jones, who does the kicking and the punting for the Falcons. And there's the kick. Caught by number 28 for the Southeast Buffaloes. Gets around two tacklers. And tackled out of bounds by Nate Campbell there. Big hit there for the Falcons. Number 28 seems to be a little shaken up after that. But he's able to walk off under his own power there. Might have gotten the wind knocked out of him. It'll be Southeast Buffalo football at the 32-yard line. They're going to take some time to check on number 28. That is, pardon me if I say this wrong, King Jones, only a freshman for the Buffaloes on that kick return. Here's the first play for Southeast offense here. Number 10 linebacker for the Falcons, Nate Campbell, is lining up looking like he's going to blitz. And it looks like they might have gotten Southeast to jump there. Yep, 5-yard penalty. False start on the Southeast offense. Looks like they're switching out already. A little less meat on the line there for the Falcons. Looks like we've got our typical linebacker, number 10, Nate Campbell, going down to nose guard. Interesting setup by the Falcon defense here. Here comes a snap for the Buffaloes, and number 22 is stopped in the backfield. That was number 22, not 20. It's hard to see numbers. So that was a tackle for a loss there, for about a 5-yard loss. So now it is 2nd and 15 for the Buffaloes. Heights defense is back in that 3-3 setup there for the defense. Our defensive backs playing pretty far off the ball, not expecting a pass here, I don't think. There's another give. Tackled there for about a 6-yard gain for the Buffaloes. Number 20. That is number 22. I don't see a 22 on the Southeast roster. But so looks to be a 7-yard gain actually for the Buffalo. So now it is 3rd and 8 on the 34-yard line. A flag there on the play. Not sure. The Heights are switching out defenders every play. Might have been an offsides on the Heights defense there, but looking to give Southeast some different looks on defense here. Ball on the 39 now here. Drop back to pass. Pass is incomplete for Southeast. That brings up a fourth and three for the Buffaloes. Looks like they're gonna bring their punt team on. So a good stand there by the Heights defense. Get the ball back here. Got number 5, John Randall, back to receive the punt. And back to punt for the Buffaloes, number 34. Marcus Jones. The kick is blocked and picked up by Nate Campbell, and he's going to take it to the house for a Falcon touchdown. Wow, great job by the Heights punt team there. Number 10. Nate Campbell there on the scoop and score. Not a lot that number 10 gets to take it into the end zone, but great to see him scoop and score on that one. Good job by the Heights punt team to make it 14-0 with 9:27 to go. Then DJ Dingle stopped in the backfield. So now it is 14-0, 9:27 to go. That two-point conversion was unsuccessful for the Falcons. But two quick scores there, looking a lot like last week's game against South High, which was a 54-6 win where most points were scored in the first quarter. So we'll see how this one goes. Now, again, to kick for the Falcons, number 55, carry on Harris Jones. And back to receive for the Buffaloes, number 7 and number 6. That is number 7, Dubbern Moore, and number 6, Tylen Smith. I'm not sure if you guys can hear, but the band in the Heights student section is making a lot of noise to try to throw off this Southeast kick return team. And here's the kick, a better kick for number 55 there. Caught by number 6. Tackled by number 10. Tackled by number 10, Nate Campbell. Southeast ball on the 34-yard line. First and 10. Oh, timeout Southeast there. And now to join me, Sergeant Yeager.
Oh, welcome.
How are you doing?
I'm good. It's a little chilly down there on the field.
Yeah, a little chilly, but you got a good view of the first two touchdowns there for the Falcons.
Yep, that was it's pretty quick 14 right there.
Yeah, that's same thing that happened last weekend against South High. Just three or four scores that were pretty quick in the first. I think we almost had 40 points in the first quarter. But now it is Southeast ball on the 34-yard line, first and 10 here with nine minutes, 20 seconds to go. Motion there, give to number two.
Didn't get the corner.
Nope. Tackled for a loss there by the height. Even looked to be a tackle by number
20.
Number 20. Caleb Roper, senior defensive end for the Falcons. That was a loss of 5 yards on the play. Brings up a 2nd and 16 on the 29-yard line.
Lots of pink. Looks good on it, and them socks look good on that uniform out there.
Yeah, they announced the pink out for tonight. Always love a good pink out. Back to pass there.
Pass, open over the middle, number 7. Ooh, didn't get it.
Let's see if they give it to him. Good catch and pitch and catch there by the Southeast offense, but looks like they're going to be just short of the first down, bringing up a 3rd and 1. See if the defense can get a stop here. Last week's game, I don't think the defense gave up a first down until closer to the end of the game.
Let's see if we can get tightened up and get the ball back.
Yeah.
We
jumped.
I think there's motion on number 75 over there on the offense.
False start on the offense there, yep. So takes him back 5 yards, brings up a 3rd and 6 now, so going to be a little tougher to get that first down. All right, now we got 3rd and 6, motion here by the Southeast. They go for a little screen pass out here.
Oh, missed tackle.
Missed the tackle there, but he's knocked out of bounds by number 34, it looks like. Might have been 34.
Stop the clock with 7:33.
Number 34, Jamison Holland, pushed him out of bounds there. There's been a lot of subbing in and out by this Heights defense. They've been giving him different looks. And it seems to be working here. Got a fourth and two on the 42-yard line here.
That's delayed. 30. Oh, up the middle.
Up the middle, and he stopped.
Stopped short.
Good.
take over on downs. He's got a short field for us.
Good stop there. He pretty much ran into a brick wall there. Good stop by the defense to get that turnover and actually get our offense on the field for more than one play. And I know you guys can't see it from your view, but the defensive coach on the field, Coach Pankratz, is always bringing the energy for those boys. Keeps the energy high and gets the defense fired up.
Playing with enthusiasm.
Yeah, gotta love it. We've got number 4, Cam Ellison, in the backfield. Motions him up. DJ Dingle in the shotgun. Drops back to pass. He's going to let it fly for number 5, John Randall.
Oh!
Just slightly underthrown there. Good coverage by the southeast corner there. Number 5, John Randall, had him beat, but just a little underthrown there by DJ. Good idea. Love the taking a shot on the first play. It's now 2nd and 10 on the 41-yard line. Heights come out in a different formation here. Trips left. Back in the shotgun, number 5, John Randall, now in the backfield.
They fake the blitz there.
Yep. Good option there.
Oh,
and he throws it out to number 4, Millison, who gets about a 5-yard gain, it looks to be. 4 or 5-yard gain. Good read by Dingle there. So that'll bring up a third and five for the Heights offense here. Oh, my bad. 3rd and 6. I'm just looking at what the scoreboard says.
Oh, you gonna keep it? Pitch it out.
Pitch it out to Cale Millison. Great snag there.
He's got the
cuts
first.
It up and he gets the first down. Runs out of bounds at the 30-yard line for Heights first down. DJ pitched it a little behind him, but Millison with a nice one-handed snag there. Normally we see 5, John Randall, in the backfield doing most of the running for the Heights offense, but he's been getting mixed in at receiver, it looks to be, this game. With his speed and his hands, I wouldn't doubt that he'd be a threat at wide receiver too.
And it keeps the defense honest. We don't have to account for him anywhere.
Yeah.
So you may get a mix-up where they put a linebacker on him that's not quite as quick.
Yeah. This time, keeper by DJ Dingle cuts it upfield to about the 11-yard line for a Heights first down. I'm doing slow math here. Normally, I'm keeping stats and have some help, but not the best at math.
Rookie.
We'll just say that was a first down.
First down. Rookie over here just trying to figure out what
to
do. Oh, cut it up.
Good
there
move
you go.
By Randall for a Heights touchdown. 12-yard run there by number 5, John Randall. A good run there by number 5, John Randall, who's a 4-star recruit and one of the top running backs in Kansas. Looks to be a southeast defender down there on the right sideline. Not sure who he is, but looked to be number 62 for the southeast defense, 63. And this is the first game, football game in October, which the reason the pink out is for Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And here at Heights, we support and We support and pray for any person affected by breast cancer, including my Aunt Brandy, who has been dealing with breast cancer for the past 2 years, but she's really been fighting hard and has a really cool story of overcoming it. So now we got the two-point conversion here for the Falcons. Give to Lafayette Washington, cuts it up into the end zone for a two-point conversion. Now 22-0. Heights is winning with 5:17 left in the first quarter. I think our kickoff team's going to see a lot of reps today.
I think so. I think they're going to get some more playing time.
Yeah, a lot of quick scores here. Number 55, Kerryon Harris-Jones to kick off here. And here's the kick. Good kick there. Caught by number 6 for Southeast.
Ooh, had a lane up the middle, but it closed quickly.
Brings it up to about the 40-yard line. Excuse me. Looked to be tackled by number 8, Isaiah Yehuda. You know, you have to be a special person to want to receive a kickoff and just run into a wall of a bunch of big dudes.
Or super fast.
Or super fast, yeah. I was at the K-State game this last weekend thinking, man, I'm not wanting to run full speed at a bunch of 200-pound grown men running full speed too.
That's why when I was in high school, I liked defense better. I played defense.
Yeah.
I liked issuing the hit, not receiving.
Oh, Cale Millis almost had him in the backfield there. Barely missed a big hit. That was a great read there.
Yep. Nice little spin move for the Southeast guy to get up to, a two-yard gain?
Yeah, 2 yard gain there. On the 42-yard line, yep. Second and 8 for the Southeast offense here. Southeast comes out in a doubles wide here. Going in the shotgun motion. They motion the running back up. Heights looks to be set up in a 3-3 here again. Not sure what that
I don't
actually
know,
what that defense is. They've been mixing up the looks.
Yeah, they weren't they
number 8
down.
Yehuda almost had another tackle for loss in the backfield, but Southeast running back number 7 broke the tackle for about a 6 yard gain, it looks to be. Now it's 3rd and 2.
Definitely was an interesting defensive line formation.
Yeah. And at the beginning of the game, it looked like they were subbing in and out every game and changing that every down and changing that formation. Now they look to be in a 4-2, 4-3, and they bring
pass
the house.
Up, screen play.
Little screen there. For a Southeast first down. But we brought the house on that one. I think they might have known what play they might have been running there. Good for a Southeast first down there. That was about a 25-yard gain, looks to be.
Collector set up for it again.
Yeah. Now a screen
swing,
to the
little swing pass to the left.
Good hit by number 24.
Nice open field tackle
by Michael Smith. He's a big hitter, man. He got ejected from the North game because they thought he had targeting, but it was just a clean, hard hit that Coach Dingle sent film to Keisha, and they said, yeah, he's unsuspended, he can play now.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, but he was on the JV squad last year, and he's just been proving himself to be a staple on the Heights defense. Southeast comes out and trips right here.
I got a false start.
False start on number 68 for the Southeast offense, and he knew it right away. Just one of those mental errors. So that brings it back 5 yards for now a second and – 18. Great opportunity for the defense to stop them here and get the ball back to our offense, who seems to be firing on all cylinders right now. Drop back to pass there. Oh. Not a great incomplete pass intended for number 10 on the southeast.
Looked like he threw it behind him a little bit and had to reach for it.
Yeah, maybe some miscommunication there. Brings up 3rd and 18 for the Southeast Buffaloes with 2:01 left in the first quarter. Come back in. Here's snap, back to pass again. Oh, taking a shot over top and just overthrew him. That was intended for number 2. Carlos Porter on the play there. Brings up a 4th and 18. Looks like Southeast bringing out their punt team here. Looks like they're not going to have anybody. Back to number.
They don't have anybody for the return. And
yeah.
It is going to go into the end zone for
a touchback.
Well, it looked like the on that last pass play, if he would have connected, he had two offensive players past our defense, so. Good thing he overthrew that.
Yeah, good break for the defense there. You know, I was talking to a few of our football guys, and they said Southeast really doesn't pass that much, but it looks like they've gone to some more pass plays than usual.
Well, when you start getting down 20 points, you're going to have to start trying to get some quick scores.
And yeah, taking some shots.
It gets you a little bit quicker.
Yeah, get some momentum going your way. Back in the backfield, number 5, John Randall for the Falcons. They're in a doubles wide here. Got two receivers kind of stacked up behind each other on the sideline here. Keep by number 2, DJ Dingle here. For about a 5-yard gain. Brings up 2nd and 5 for the Falcon offense with a minute 30, and the clock is running left in the first quarter. I wouldn't be surprised if they ran one more play and just let it run out. They go back to that same formation with two receivers stacked up on the bottom of your screen here. You can't really see them. Fell on his own fumble there. Ball just popped out. Carry there by DJ Dingle for a
got a couple yards on
for
it.
2-yard gain. He gained more yards diving over for the fumble than he did running. Might have just popped out, got a bad grip on it. Number 6, number 81 coming out of the game. Number 12, Lafayette Washington coming in. Heights coming out into doubles to the left. One receiver on the top of your screen here. Give to number 5, John Randall. He stopped right at the line of scrimmage for no gain. Now we got fourth and two here for the Heights offense. It looks like they're gonna punt it here. They're gonna punt it away with nope. They're not even going to get the punt off because that is the end of the first quarter. Heights 22, Southeast 0. And we will be right back. here to start the second quarter here for the Falcon offense. They're here to punt it away to start the second quarter. Number 55, carry on Harris Jones. Back to kick number 7 for Southeast.
Oh, it's a
Was it a fake?
It was a fake. He took the
snap. It looks like they got it.
Yep, they got the first down.
Wow, smart play there by the Heights.
Snap to the up back, and he got the first down.
Did you see what number that was for the
No, it kind of surprised me because I'm waiting for the punt. I'm watching a punter, and all of a sudden I see the up back take the ball and run. Number 4? Yep.
Number 6.
Yeah.
Number 6, Avante Scales there to get the first down from on the fake punt for the Falcons. They're back, trips left with DJ Dingle and John Randall in the backfield.
Dropping back to pass.
DJ takes a shot down the field. Oh, what a pass.
Nice pass.
Huge play by the Falcon offense there. Big shot to number 9, Tavion Johnson there. That was a huge play, a bomb by DJ Dingle. Great throw.